All right, so Valentine's Day is tomorrow, and if there's one person who is like just militantly single,
yeah,
you know, and
it's true,
yeah, I mean, she, like, oh, where have you ever considered? No,
no, never.
But what if they're nope?
No thanks.
Yeah,
nope,
she's just not interested.
I'm good. I am good.
Yeah, I think you get to a point that you just kind of realize what your life is going to be. Mm. You know, you hit a certain point where it's like, all right, you know what? At this point, there's no chance I'm having kids.
Yeah, this is it.
Or mm-hmm. for women, you get to a point where mm-hmm. you couldn't even if you wanted to.
Right.
No. Mm-hmm.
Like Ravy. Jeez,
no
her
eggs
insides
up
are
in there.
Her insides are dust.
That
at this
is a
point.
Rocky place.
Yeah. You ever see like photos of like old abandoned amusement parks
there
and stuff?
Oh yeah.
That's there
like,
it is.
That's like Ravy's reproductive system.
Oh.
It's not gonna happen.
But I mean, look, Woody Greg Menace, you've known me for forever.
Yeah.
Do you believe I'm not good where I am?
No. And I think that's what differentiates you from other women who are single and they go, oh, I'm going to do my Valentine's Day and just have some, you know, Chablis with the ladies. I think they wish they were not single. You, I believe, like being single.
I don't think Woody believes that.
No, I do.
You do?
Yeah. I think she doesn't want to be married, but I know she's got people in her life from time to time to come satisfy certain needs.
Well, that's
that's not like
break glass if needed.
Those aren't boyfriends,
do you believe
girlfriends.
I'm not good.
No, I think you're fine. I think you're fine with that. I think you are not a person who's going to cohabitate with a romantic partner.
She said even if she fell in love with somebody you would have separate homes.
That's right.
Right.
Yeah,
they
see
connect.
That's the part I don't believe. I believe that Ravy is fine, she's content, she's good. But I believe if she found that right person, we would see a totally different person in Ravy.
Okay.
And she's going to lie to us and say no.
No.
But it'll be like,
well,
how Seabass is.
I can't tell you. I can't lie to you and say no because it hasn't
it'll be
happened.
Like Seabass in public with whatever girl.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I would not
PDA.
Be that.
Dude.
Yeah. Just because
I
I've seen
believe
it.
I believe think Ravy would be that way.
Well, anyway, Ravy says if you're single on Valentine's Day, don't be one of these people that are upset. Don't be sad. Be psyched.
Change your thinking. That's all it is. It's an attitude adjustment. Don't just wallow in misery. Think about what's great in your life.
Yeah, and there's so many reasons that Ravy says that it's awesome to be single.
I'm going to help you guys out. And this has always been my number one on the list. The top reason to stay single is that you just don't have to compromise. You don't have to make deals. You do what you want. So if you want to stay in, you stay in. If you want to go out, you go out. If you want to say no to something, you say no. If you want to say yes, say yes. It's up to you.
That sounds pretty easy.
You eat what you want to eat.
Well, it's so simple, which segues into socially, you spend time with who you want to, which I think is really key too. The people that you love, the people that you want to see. You're not dragged somewhere to be the plus one for your significant other, where you know no one, and it's what if your significant other is just flitting off, talking to other people, and there you are.
Forced to socialize.
With people that aren't your friends and people that you don't know. That sounds awful to me.
Well, that plays into Ravy's social anxiety.
I do have social anxiety, too.
Because that would be fine. I'm like, whatever, just talk to people.
I mean, there's some people who just talk to anybody.
Yeah. Sure. Menace would tell people how he's on 27, 25 radio
shows. Yeah, I would.
Well, for me, that doesn't. It's not the social part of it. It's just the activity. Like, I don't want to go pumpkin patch picking or whatever, hiking or whatever the hell stupid crap.
Yeah. That sounds fun to me.
Yeah.
You never have to deploy the excuse generator. We get calls in here. I need an excuse for my girlfriend so I can go to Vegas with my friends. What?
Right.
What? What? Just go to Vegas.
Right.
You don't need an excuse generator. You say, honey, I'm going to go to Vegas with my friends. But there are people in those relationships that are like, ooh, I got to make something up.
Because it's not worth it.
Yeah.
It's not worth the
gonna
grief.
She's going to be mad or he's going to be upset.
Yeah. Because it's not like, well, what am I supposed to do?
It's like, what? Well,
figure it out.
This one comes directly from Woody. And it's something I had never considered. But this is a repeated theme. No, you don't have to have a heavy conversation before bedtime.
Ugh, it's the worst.
And I feel like that's
like, why are we bringing this up now?
That's a thing because, you know, people have been holding on to something all day, all day, all day. And now it's bedtime. I just want to unburden myself before
trying to unwind.
Go to sleep.
Yeah. You're trying to turn your brain off. You're trying to make it so it's easier to fall asleep. And you've had all day to bring this up. All day. And this is the time that you're picking?
So that, like, people just stew in the juice.
Yeah.
And then, you know, they want to get it out right before bed. That sounds terrible. This makes the list every year. I don't know why people insist on sharing beds and trying to sleep together. People make all kinds of noises. People are restless. People are on different schedules. You need quiet time to get quality rest. And I contend it's next to impossible. If you sleep with a snorer, if you sleep with somebody with restless leg syndrome, you know.
Or even if they just roll over.
Rolls
up,
right. Pees a lot.
Yeah.
I have, that makes no sense to me. You can have two beds, have them, and sleep in them.
Yeah. 714 saying, I super agree with the separate beds. We are fairly average sized people in a Cal King size bed, but I would prefer to have my own.
I think so. Spread.
It is a very strange
phenomenon. It is so weird to me.
Yeah.
It is so weird to me. I do
sleep way better when my wife's out of town.
Yeah.
Of course. It just makes sense. Like, Greg, how many times have you come in here? Oh, God, I'm exhausted. Mario was snoring all night. Move! You have another room!
Yeah. But that requires unmaking that bed. And
So you'd rather have a night of no sleep than make a second bed.
But I thought you loved doing stuff like that. I thought you loved making beds and vacuuming carpets.
The guest room is like that room that you just look at. Unless it's being used by a guest.
I think you need to reconsider that, Greg. That mentality, that thinking. All right,
so we're going over Ravy's reasons why it's awesome to be single. Don't be sad on Valentine's Day if you're single. Be psyched.
This is a big one for me, especially. I don't get how people just keep talking. We talk all day at work. Uh-huh. People talk all day at work. You're at work. You're talking. Then you go home and it's just more talking. Oh my God. I am someone that really does appreciate quiet time. Time to just be.
Yeah.
You know, the only conversation I'll have is with a cat. Hey, how's it going over there?
Hey, cat.
And that's it. But just the thought of continuing to talk, I don't know. It just kind of freaks me out almost. Like, can we just sit here and be quiet?
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
All the talking. So, hey, if you get to go home and you don't have to talk, rip. Winning.
And this has been a fairly new thing in my household, but like my wife, and I don't know if she's just at the end of her rope or whatever with the kids, but all conversations in my house between my wife and my kids, or my kids, like from my one kid to the other kid, is always at a yelling volume.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
God. Isn't that your wife's family?
This is what I... Would you listen to me, please? All right, look. 4 + 6 equal... I'm like, oh my God. And so of course, you know...
You've been up since 2 a.m.
It's echoing and it's giving me anxiety.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that your wife's side of the family? They do that, right? They yell.
They are a loud family.
Yeah. And my father-in-law is, I think, half deaf from working around these giant printing presses his whole career.
Okay.
And then in their house, it's all tile and hardwood floors. And so for him to be able to hear the TV, he has to have it like at 1,000 decibels.
Right.
And now they're talking over the TV.
Oh, my God.
Uh-huh. And it's just, and then you got kids and dogs and everybody else running around. Like, I have to go outside sometimes and just sit on the front porch.
Yeah, soothe
it. Just for a couple minutes. Because, I feel the anxiety. Yeah. I get you, Rave. I get you.
This is something that's come up directly on this show because of Woody and Menace. The what's for dinner conversation.
Yeah.
I hate that conversation.
If you're single, you never have to have that.
Never.
What am I feeling like for dinner? Okay, I guess I'll get that.
Whatever I want.
Like, what do you think about it, the picture you posted when your family was away and you went to Denny's in your slides and socks?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Tell me you weren't just in ecstasy.
I wore to Denny's what I wore to bed, which is some athletic shorts, which I know is ironic. Slides, like just like these slipper type things.
Yeah, your slides.
With socks.
Yeah, and some ratty t-shirt and an old zipper hoodie.
Right.
And that was it. Threw a hat on, went to Denny's,
and I fit right in. That's the dress code for Denny's.
Yeah, fit right in.
Like, if you don't even want to eat dinner, you don't have to eat. Maybe just want a snack or something. Yeah. Just snack.
Yeah, that's what's crazy. I eat way less when Nacho's out of town.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I tell her, like, every meal doesn't have to be an event. It doesn't have to be a discussion. We don't have to go to some elaborate place.
Sure. It could just be a box of cornbread.
Yeah. Yeah, that's it. It doesn't. I'll eat anything.
You don't have to pretend to enjoy something you don't.
Yes.
I think that is super exhausting, whether it's a restaurant you're not a fan of, watching a show you don't really like, going to an amusement park or a sporting event or the mall. You don't have to pretend, oh, yeah, this is great. I think that's so exhausting to keep that up. And there are those people out there, just because their significant other's going or doing that or thinks that they like it, they go and do. I feel bad for those people.
Yeah. Aww.
My
wife and I don't operate that way. She knows there's just certain things. Like, she loves going to theater shows.
Oh, yeah, she just knows
I'm not going.
Oh, hell no.
Hell no.
Petty arguments and drama. When you're single, you have none of those. No arguments over the dishes. Either you do them or you don't, but you're left to your own devices. Either they're there or you're not. Who are you going to fight with? Yourself? Because you haven't done the dishes? Or yourself?
Self-loathing.
Because the toilet seat's up? Or yourself? No petty arguments. People get in fights and don't talk to each other over the dumbest stuff. Drama, petty arguments, the worst. I'm glad I don't have to deal with any of that.
Yeah. Half of our redneck news stories are a fight over who had the last hot dog.
Over a television show or someone ate my chicken. Yeah.
The silver lining for me is every once in a while it ends with me getting the silent treatment, which is a blessing. That's not a punishment.
The silent treatment.
Yeah.
I'll throw this extra one in. Especially for the ladies.
Like, I'll start a fight just to get to silent treatment.
It's like sending a kid to their room.
Yeah.
Wow, big punishment.
There's no more stigma attached to masturbation. Guys have been able to get their rocks off so easily for such a long time. The toy game is strong. Ladies, self-satisfaction is out there. So if you're horning, it can be taken care of. It's all right. And finally... single life, I think, rules because you can focus on becoming the person you really want to be. So many people out there establish their own self-worth based on the person they're with or their kids. That is sad to me. Take the time. Figure yourself out. Don't let society pressure you into thinking, you know, I should be here, but I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
Focus on yourself. Learn what you like. Learn who you are. And then that will make it easier, I think, to couple up in the future if you want to. Because if you just let society pressure you, you'll be miserable and you're dragging somebody down with you. So,
wow, Rave.
That
was heavy.
I love being single. I think it's great. But if you don't want to be single, there are dating apps. Whatever city you're in, check out activities. There's always activities. There's clubs. There's all kinds of things you can enjoy. Do a little research because if you want to meet somebody, you can. So don't be sad, be psyched. You're all right. You're all right.